All right, guys, Corey here. I've traveled outside of Austin today to a place that I actually grew up, my hometown. It's called Flatonia, Texas. I had 31 kids in my senior class here. There was 400 from K through 12. There was about 1,000 people in all of my hometown. So some of the guys from back home, they asked me, would I drive down and clean their mother's carpet? I'm like, certainly I will. You know, the guys I went to high school with. So, you know, I don't charge a trip fee to come back home because, you know, they don't have these services out, you know, in the countryside like this. So you're going to get them. You got to get somebody out of the city that wants to charge you a ton of money to come out and do them. So, you know, I'm coming down here basically out of respect for my hometown, basically. So let me show you the terrain here in the house. I just did all the vacuuming in a different video and I pre-sprayed one room. So let me turn the camera in and we'll take a quick look here. All right. Now what's so unique is this particular house here, this is the aunt of my first high school girlfriend. So we've met, you know, I dated her, her niece, I guess that would about in 1990. So it's been a few days since we dated, and it's been a few wives ago too at this point, you know, being that I'm 46 years old. So, but at any rate, you know, people in a small town, they generally stay in contact from, you know, from kindergarten on, and that's what I've done with basically everybody in the hometown. This area hasn't been sprayed yet, the bedroom has. Here's another little room to do here. Reason why I'm here is because there's been an animal that's been peeing a little bit, so I'm gonna brought enough peroxide to hopefully end all of that. I'm gonna clean this rug here, this carpet here rather, I'm sorry. So I'm gonna clean this rug and then roll up the rug and get it out of here and clean underneath it. I am gonna scoot the couch and the chairs around a little bit, kind of musically, you know, and clean under them and put them back where they are. And I'm gonna clean under this guy here. This is the last room here. So, I'm gonna take my little orbital machine down here and get started. And it's gonna be a little more difficult because it's a lighter colored carpet and you have to get it, it's a frisee as well, so it'd be a little more difficult, take a little longer to clean. Anyway, I'm gonna set up here and I'll be right back. All right, I did one room here, so take a look, come out really, really, really good. I hate to put any footprints on it, so we'll take a look here. Everything that was, there was a few dots and spots out here, but overall the whole thing just lightened up a whole lot whiter. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna pre-spray this section of hall here. There was urine right here, so this got a big shot of just plain old peroxide when I got here. I'm probably gonna spray both of these rooms at the same time and clean them both and then move to the living room, where I'll do the rug and the room and then finish up in the other room right over there, the dining room last. Dining rooms are where animals love to pee because people don't go in there that much and they don't get caught. You know, they go in there a couple times a year, like Christmas and Thanksgiving, and then the rest of the time, animals just kind of have their way with the place. So if you're gonna leave carpet out of anywhere, if you're building a new home, leave it out of the dining area. Dogs would love to pee on it. All right, it's coming up next. Let's see what you guys are seeing here. Yeah, it's, I don't believe this will convey, but this is my, basically my new mix plus hydrogen peroxide. Working really well on a very light colored frisé. Out pretty darn good. There's only a camera person. I had one for like a day. Gonna change out the cotton underneath it, I believe. All right, time to catch up here with the camera. Did the hallway and stopped right there. Turned and went in this room. Did in here. I haven't groomed it yet. It's just been clean. So turning absolutely great. So now I've got this room over here I'm gonna do. And then after this, I've got two more rooms to go and a rug. So let's see if I can capture some of this on video. I will do my best. Hopefully I can see it on my Apple Watch here. Yep, see a little bit. take a look here. Showed some of that. Anyway, the hall, showed this. All right, now this guy here is what we just cleaned. Turned out really well. This was a little more challenging around the area right there. Came out all right, but that was a double clean right there. So now, between phone calls and text, I've got to finish off the rest of it. So I'm going to do this rug and then take it, I don't even know where. I have no idea. I guess it's going to have to roll up and go on the kitchen floor here. Then I've got to trip over it to get out of the house. But basically, I'm going to clean it and roll it up and then clean the floor under it. And this room here is what we're left with here. I'm running a little bit of Fabuloso today. There was mention of pet odor, and I don't think anything smells better than a green Fabuloso. People love that stuff, and it sticks around a really long time. All right, just pour push spray in, and I will be back. All right, rug first. Rug's been sprayed, the room has it. Complete the rug, and I found a brand new towel that I made. It seems like the ones that I've made, they're thicker, and the fibers of the terry cloth are longer, so it seems to be a little more aggressive, and it's lasting, they're lasting really well. So I do plan on making more. Not really a lot to see there. It was a rug, now it's a clean rug. So I'm gonna roll this guy up and get it out of the way, and I've got these two chairs and this couch to contend with. I'm gonna probably going to scoot everything forward, basically bring all the chairs forward and clean around the back side of the room, and then push everything back and then clean the rest of the room. So I see it going down. It looks like my new cleaner I came up with last week is a huge hit. It's doing incredibly well where it shouldn't. I haven't had this much luck cleaning a frisée, much less a white frisée, ever. This is incredible how well it's working. That was a mixture of what I've got. Try to remember here. I've got one capful of the plant-based Tide, two capfuls of the OxiClean White Revive, and one big shot of Dawn dishwashing liquid into a 1 gallon container, and then metered out again into the sprayer. So it's doing an incredibly good job. Another thing, cotton is playing a huge role, a very significant role in how well this is cleaning out of there. I don't believe that you would see this much success if I were using microfiber. You got to know when and where you can use what. All right, now we're gonna do this area right here. Let me give it a little courtesy ammonia, just because it's a heavy walk area here. So just a little light ammonia mist over the heavy traffic areas to take the pH up to about 12, and then have it back at a 7 when it's dry. Can't really ask for a better situation than that in cleaning, especially the carpet. take a look here. So what it did, this area to here has been cleaned. So all of this here, I'm really pleased with it, especially here where all this traffic area was. All cleaned out really well. Now I'm clean to here. So basically what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna push back the three pieces of furniture and we'll groom it first, then push the furniture back. And we're on plastic legs. So we're good with that aspect of it. So I'm gonna groom it and push it back, and then we'll be doing the whole big middle out here next. This one has been used on two sides now, so I'm gonna switch this one out. There were my other homemade towels. All right, this is my other homemade towel. These are working better. I just need to set aside some time to make some more of these. I'm really impressed with the way they clean and the way they stay together. That one there was a little bit of a miscut when I originally cut it. So it's a circle that's challenged. It's not actually a circle, it's more like an egg. There we go. I wanted to do all this by myself. All right, I'm gonna groom this guy out and we will reconvene over here in this other final room. Thank goodness, because I've got an hour and a half drive back and I'm probably supposed to be there about right now, if I had to guess. So that's just, it's hard to give people an exact arrival time, so I do lots of texting during the day. I'll be back. All right, we're all done now. So take a look here, this is the final room, the dining room, turned out good. Don't want to put any more footprints there than I have to. I'm gonna have to put a few getting in and out of here. Anyway, living room turned out good. You can see where the rug lives. So, got it to return pretty close, but you're never gonna match. Because you've got everything going on out here, like I've explained before. You've got sun fade, you've got dye loss and everything else, and here you've got carpet that's been covered and protected from everything. All right, so now I got this room here, and we got the rug. So the carpet's got to dry, then the rug will be drug out and allowed to dry. This room here, and we'll take a quick look in here. All right, guys, this has been a little trip to my hometown to work for people that I've known my whole life. So that's not many people can say they work for somebody that they've known for 46 years, you know, minus the first 5 years before kindergarten, you know, so 41 years, whatever, basically. But yeah, I've known these people my whole life. And it feels good to drive an hour and a half to work for somebody you've known your whole life. There's something about that that's nice. And I also enjoy getting out of the city. There's a significant difference between people you meet in the city and people you meet in a small town. I was raised in a small town, so I understand the mentality. It's a closely knit community. And, when you live in a small town, you basically have to live a pretty clean life. So that's what I enjoy about coming back and visiting the small town here. You'll find a lot better people here. A lot less people, but a whole lot better people. People that will go out of their way to help you, not go out of their way to mess you over, which you'll find in larger cities. Thanks for watching, guys. I wish I had more time to show you around the hometown, and I would, but I don't. I've got to quickly pack up and head back up to Austin, drive an hour and a half, and do some more of this. So, see you later in the day. Thanks for watching, and God bless.